Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint, and in this video I will be showing you how to create zoom through text intro transition effect in PowerPoint. Let's have a look what we will be creating today. So as you can see, the effect starts with a see-through text written on the slide where a video is being played in the background. And suddenly it changes its colors, and then the slide beautifully zooms into the text and the video in the background enters into a full frame. Then an intro text makes its entrance and the animation finally ends with a cinematic dip to black transition effect. Isn't it interesting? The effect might look difficult, but believe me, it is just a combination of some PowerPoint animation techniques, most of which have already been explained on my channel in separate videos. However, I have combined all those effects into this single animation effect, and in a couple of minutes, you will also be able to create this kind of effect in PowerPoint very easily. Let's get started with the tutorial. So the foremost requirement to create this animation is to download a video background. I will be providing the links of two websites, which are pexel.com and pixabay.com. Both the websites offer tons of stock footages which are available for free download. For example, here I will search city and then choose the orientation as horizontal. Click on videos here, and then I get all the footages related to my keyword, that is city. You can download any video by clicking on free download. I will be providing the links for these websites in the YouTube show notes below. Now go to your PowerPoint slide and insert this video. Make sure that it fills the whole slide. Select the video. Go to the playback tab and here select start automatically. Now we need to create that see-through text. As I have already told that I have combined the various animation effects which have been already explained on my channel, and in my last video only I had explained how to create this see-through text in PowerPoint. However, the users who are new to this channel and have not subscribed it yet, I will again explain the process, which is really very simple. Go to the insert tab and insert a rectangle shape in the slide to cover the whole slide. Insert a text box and write your desired text. I will change the font style to the bold font, which is my favorite, and increase its size. If you don't know how to download and install any new font in PowerPoint, then I have already made a separate video for this and will be providing the link for the same in the description box below. Now, in order to convert this text into see-through text, select the rectangle shape first, and then while holding the shift key, select the text box. Guys, do remember that the order of selection should be the same. First the rectangle shape and then the text box. Then go to the shapes format tab, click on merge shapes and hit combine. Let's see what we have achieved so far. Alright, so now it's time to begin with the animation process. Select the shape, go to the animations tab and add grow or shrink animation effect to it. Open the animations pane, right click the effect and open the effect options. Here in the size settings, add a custom value to a very large amount, say 6500%. Under the timings tab, set the duration time to about 10 to 15 seconds. Now as you can see, small black parts get visible on one side of the screen as the text zooms out. And to solve this, I will add a left motion path effect to the shape. Open the effect options of this effect and reduce the smooth start and smooth end to 0 seconds. Under the timings tab, select start with previous, and for the duration time, you need to experiment the duration time and see how the motion path effect matches best to the grow animation effect. To start with, let's keep the duration time the same as that of the grow animation effect, which is 10 seconds. Let's have a look what we have achieved so far. Okay, so the black parts are gone, but the motion path effect is taking too much time. And after repeated trial and error, I kept the motion path duration to 3 seconds and the groove animation duration to 15 seconds. And this is the final output. Guys, if you noticed, the effect which I had shown you in the very starting of the video, just observe how the colors of the text get changed randomly before it zooms out into the video. Actually, I have adapted this effect from one of my previous videos, and those who are the old subscribers of this channel must be knowing the trick to do the same. However, for the newcomers, I will again explain this trick to them in this video. To create this effect, you need to open the selection pane first by going to the home tab and then clicking on select. Rename this existing shape to black since its color is black. Duplicate this by pressing Ctrl plus D and overlap the two shapes completely. Go to the shapes format tab and change its color to red. And in the selection pane, rename the shape as red. And now you need to repeat this process for as many colors as you want. I would recommend that you use at least 8 to 10 different colors. After duplicating and modifying these shapes, you will notice that the animation effects also get copied with each shape. So remove all these effects except that of the original black shape. Now select all the shapes except the original black one from the selection pane by holding the Ctrl key and go to the animations tab and add disappear animation effect to all these new shapes. In the animation pane, reorder the effects and move these disappear effects above the original grow animation effect of the black shape like this. Select start with previous for all the effects, and now all I need to do is play with the delay setting of each animation effect. Let me show you how this works. For the very first white shape, I will add a delay of 2.5 seconds. And then for the very next shape, I will increase the delay by 0.10 seconds. So 2.6 for the gray shape, 2.7 for the sea blue, 2.8 for the pink, and so on. after the last shape, when the turn for the original grow animation of the black shape comes, here we need to increase the delay not by 0.1 seconds but by 2 seconds from the delay of the very previous animation effect. For example, if I had set the delay of the red shape to 3.3 seconds, I will set the delay of the black shape to about 5.5 seconds. Similarly, I will set the delay of the motion path effect also to 5.5 seconds, that is the same as that of the grow animation effect. And this is how it looks when I play the slideshow. Amazing. Next, I want to insert a text. Write your desired text and arrange it in the slide. Since I have written my text in two separate text boxes, I will group both these text boxes together and make it a single one. I will change the font color to white and place the text on my original slide. To place it in the center of the slide, click on the Align tab, then Align Center, and then Align Middle. For the animation part, add a fade entrance effect to the text box, increase the duration time to 2 seconds, select Start with Previous, and for the delay time, add 2 seconds more than the original black shape animation. Like I will set the delay time to 7 seconds. Then add a grow or shrink animation effect to the text box. Open the effect options and set the size to 50%. Under the timings tab, select Start with Previous, set the duration time to about 12 or maybe 15 seconds. Also, set the delay time to the same as that of the fade animation, which is 7 seconds. And now let's have a look on our final animation effect. Beautiful. And now, only one last animation is left to be applied, which will make this effect complete, and that animation effect is the cinematic dip to black transition effect. Since the video is already getting long, I will explain the dip to black transition in my next video. So kindly subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you may get notified of my upcoming video. So that's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.